attackers use us. We're their best attribute when it comes to infecting an organisation.
This was about education. This was about understanding what is and isn't a crime. You can go from a year in prison to life.
The North Koreans sent $1 billion worth of payment instructions, and the Federal Reserve paid out on about 100 million.
The biggest danger is not the criminal on the inside, but it's the good guy on the inside that lets the criminal on the outside get in. The best route into cybersecurity, any route into cybersecurity, what is so exciting now are the huge number of opportunities. In my day, you stumbled into it. Now there are so many bright people choosing to come into the industry, and there is just so much more training available. It is the most exciting thing of all is the new talent that's flooding into our work.
Bit of an odd story, really. I started off waitressing, I worked in bars, and then I went to university as a mature student and did forensics. I did a module in digital forensics, fell in love with that, changed my degree, and never looked back.
Right from my very first qualification, I've been looking at how do people interact with information? How do they use it? How do they protect it? How do they secure it? I then spent an awful lot of time working as an IT trainer, and any IT trainer will tell you that most of your job is dealing with people's frustrations. The computer won't let me do this. If it was obvious what to do, you wouldn't need training. So a lot of the time you're saying, here is this immovable thing, this computer which is not going to change. Let me show you how to get something useful out of it. So that's where I actually started working at the Bank of England as an IT trainer there.
You look at the world and you think of what's different, and the world in my journey, let's say, has changed drastically in the world of IT. And you look at the world and you think, where's it going? Internet of Things, cloud, cybersecurity. And when I thought about that word cybersecurity, I thought, wow, that's interesting. That's where the world is only going to need more protection.
One of our sort of success stories, and we're still working with this individual, he's compromised a network of one of his friends at the time, and he's also sent a lot of traffic to Notwick, which has caused a lot of disruption at school. This individual is 14 at the time. He's incredibly gifted. I mean, incredibly gifted. And he was challenging himself. He was continually trying to just get better. You could argue that there was a little bit of intent in some of his actions, but was he going to be a criminal all his life? Was court going to be the right place? No. We set up an action plan where we would support, and this was about, first initially, about education. This was about understanding what is and isn't a crime, as I've mentioned before, so that, you know, and why and what the consequences were. So why you shouldn't do it and what the consequences were. So, you know, you can go from a year in prison to life. What is also important to these individuals, and to him specifically, was that the support mechanism with his family was assisted. So currently what we're working with now is a placement in industry for him. Now that's a huge success in terms of, this is an individual who could cause a lot of problems, but has bought into and understands the positives of his skill set, and is getting, you know, the recognition that he personally wanted. We're below where we would be able to get him a job, but that's why it's successful, because we've got somebody who is really skilled, really gifted, and now industry are looking at supporting us.
So the Ladies of London Hacking Society, it's literally what it says on the tin. So it's a society where women come together of all ages over the age of 18, and they basically have some cocktails or some wine, some food, and then we literally handhold teach them hacking. So we do that, A, so that they learn about offensive security, and B, so that they understand how to defend against attacks. So we've had some incredible success stories, actually. One that really springs to mind is a woman that was a veterinary surgeon. Did a fantastic job, incredibly dedicated, and she's now got a job as a DevSecOps person. So basically she's doing secure software development, and she's actually doing a fantastic job.
There is a new dawn in education and awareness, which I have been waiting a professional lifetime for. There's a new generation of practitioners, organisations, which are frankly just amazing. They are doing now what I wanted to do 30 years ago. That I identified that people, the human layer, was going to be critical. Now, run that forward 40 years, it's only in the last 5 years that the cybersecurity community, the CISO world, have recognized this as fundamental to their success.